At ye old fancy schmancy jewelry store, the butcher strikes again.
This is a robbery.
Robbery isn't a word. Do you mean robbery?
Maybe.
Let me get this straight, Smelly Wiener Man.
Smelly Wiener Man?
You expect me to put our priceless jewels into that filthy bag?
Well, yeah.
And if I refuse, I assume you'll touch me with one of your disgusting meat products.
Disgusting?
Freeze, butcher!
Word girl, how did you find me?
You dropped your list. You can safely escape now, sir.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
What?
I'll have you know that I would have either outwitted or overpowered this oaf.
Really?
I certainly don't need to be saved by a dirty monkey and a little girl in a Halloween costume.
Rude.
Exactly.
And pompous.
Okay, you lost me there.
Pompous. It means snobby and full of yourself.
I am not pompous. I am as wonderful as I think I am.
Now that's pompous.
Listen to someone who's only a little older, but a whole lot wiser than you.
A little older?
Little girls are better seen and not heard.
Yes, but with that tacky outfit, perhaps she's better not seen and not heard.
Reginald, you are a spring, darling.
I'm good at everything.
Pompous?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, I think I got it.
Good for you.
Thanks. Well, goodbye. Roast of Fury!
That's twice the butcher has escaped from me. Maybe I need a little advice.
Oh, bravo. Excellent job stopping the bad guy.
Thanks. Captain Heavy Face, say goodbye to these two pompous people for me, would you?
No!
Oh, the humanity!
Oh, the germs!
Come on, CHF, to Professor Boxleitner's lab!
Where will the butcher strike next? Who is Professor Boxleitner? Will these two pompous people hold a grudge against Captain Huggy Face?
I'm calling my lawyer!
Well, I guess we have the answer to that question.
But tune in next time for the answers to the other questions on another exciting installment of Word Girl!